Hello and welcome to Deep Dive Dance channel. In this video, we will have a look at 20 most influential and famous choreographers of the 20th century. We will briefly talk about most extraordinary artists who have made a huge contribution to development of dance as an independent art form. Keep in mind that this list is split in two parts and is constructed in chronological order by birth year of each artist and is a subject to a personal opinion. Nevertheless, each choreographer covered in this video deserves their own full video for their artistic achievements, which we are planning on making in the future. So consider to subscribe to our channel and hit the bell so you don't miss when those videos come out. And here's our 20 greatest choreographers of 20th century. Let's begin. First on the list we have Mary Wigman, German dancer and a true pioneer of modern expressive dance. Her impact on dance throughout Central Europe changed the course of dance history. Mary Wigman's idea was to liberate dance from traditional predetermined steps by use of improvisation and honoring of an internal sense of motion, rhythm, and expressive gesture. Her choreographic repertoire spans more than 45 years and includes works that were vital in establishing modern dance statue as an independent art form. Vaslav Nijinsky. Often regarded as one of the greatest ballet dancers in history. Unfortunately, no filming of his performances survived to our days, which probably also added to his mythical fame. Nijinsky was Polish-born Russian dancer. A turning point for his career was his meeting with Sergei Diaghilev, wealthy patron of the arts. Nijinsky, along with Anna Pavlova, became main attraction and leading artist during first Russian seasons in Paris, organized by Diaghilev. Later, with Diaghilev's support, Nijinsky began to work as a choreographer himself, created revolutionary movement in his shows, moving away from traditional flowing movements of mainstream ballet. His radical angular movement combined with heavy sexual overtones caused a riot in the theater of Champs-Élysées when Le Sac des Printemps was premiered in Paris. In 1919, at the age of just 30 years old, Vaslav had a nervous breakdown and his career effectively ended. He was diagnosed with schizophrenia and never recovered, spending over 30 years in and out of psychiatric hospitals. Tragic end for a true genius. Marta Graham is an American modern dancer and choreographer. In over 50 years of her career, she created more than 180 works, from solos to large-scale pieces, in most of which she danced herself. She gave modern dance new depth as a vehicle for intense and forceful expression of primal emotions. For Marta Graham, the dance, like the spoken drama, can explore the spiritual and emotional essence of human beings. For more than 10 years, Graham Dance Company consisted solely of women, but later expansion of her team were beginning to call for men as well. To this day, Marta Graham Dance Company continues to be one of the leading and important dance company in the world. She was the first creator of modern dance to devise a truly universal dance technique out of the movement she developed in her choreography. George Balanchine was a Georgian-American ballet choreographer born in St. Petersburg, Russia, who is one of the most influential 20th century choreographers. People often regard to him as father of American ballet. He was a co-founder of Fosse School of American Ballet and of a New York City Ballet. His choreography is characterized by plotless ballets with minimal costume and decor, performed to classical and neoclassical music. He was a choreographer known for his musicality. He worked extensively with leading composers of his time. Balanchine wrote himself, "We must first realize that dancing is an absolutely independent art, not merely a secondary accompanying one. I believe that it is one of the great arts. The important thing in ballet is the movement itself. A ballet may contain a story, but visual spectacle is the essential element. The choreographer and the dancer must remember that they reach the audience through the eye. It is illusion created which convinces the audience, much as it is with the work of a musician." It is easy to say that to these days, nearly every ballet company in the world has Balanchine ballets in their regular repertoire, making it absolute classics of dance. Next on the list we have Frederick Ashton, who was a founding choreographer of another important dance company, the Royal Ballet in London. Interestingly, he first saw ballet when Anna Pavlova performed in Lima in 1917, later claiming, "From the end of that evening, I wanted to dance." Ashton's style is distinctive for its epalman, the way the head and the shoulders are held. In his works, he combines elegance and breathtaking technical demand. In 1963, Ashton created Margaret and Armand, especially for the new partnership of Margot Fonteyn and Rodolphe Nureyev, two greatest ballet dancers of 20th century. During his career, he developed the distinctive English style and left vast corpus of works that are regularly performed by the Royal Ballet and companies around the world. Another woman on the list is Birgit Cullberg, who was one of the most prominent representatives of the realistic dance drama that emerged in post-war Europe. She was a pioneer of ballet created for television. Curious to know that Birgit only started her professional training at the age of 27 and could easily become painter of writer, both disciplines she has studied in Stockholm University. Her ballets, with the strong dramatic element, found their way into almost every ballet company, and Miss Julie has been staged in 36 productions around the world. To give the choreographer a platform to create works in her native country, the Cullberg Ballet was founded in 1967 by the Swedish government. In the early 1960s, she was captivated by television as a dance medium, with her revolutionary ideas in creating movement directly for the camera. She renewed her international fame and became true pioneer of ballet created for television. Back to America, we arrive to Merce Cunningham, one of the greatest American dance artists. His seven-decade career was distinguished by constant innovation, in which he expanded the frontiers of dance by closely collaborating with other contemporary art forms. During his career, Merce Cunningham created 180 repertory dances and more than 700 events, in which he knit together movement phrases from the past and future works into a choreographic event that could be performed anywhere. Defined by precision and complexity, Cunningham's dances combined intense physicality and intellectual rigor. He challenged traditional ideas of dance, such as the role of dancers and the audience, the limitations of stage, and the relationship between movement and beauty. In the 1940s, Merce Cunningham and his life partner, composer John Cage, developed a radical new concept. Music and dance could exist independently within the same performance. The dancer's movement would no longer be tied to the rhythm, mood, and structure of music. Instead, all forms of art could stand alone, simply sharing a common space and time. John Cranko was born in South Africa. He was a member of Sadler Wells Ballet, which later became the Royal Ballet. He has retired at the age of 23 to fully dedicate on his career as choreographer. In 1961, he was invited to Stuttgart Ballet. His arrival signaled the beginning of heyday for this company. The premiere of Cranko's ballet Romeo and Juliet in 1962 became a milestone for the company. Acclaimed by both audiences and the critics, this production signaled the beginning of the famous era of Stuttgart Ballet. Cranko is famous for inviting young dancers from his group to try their hands at the choreography. These include Yiri Kilian and John Neumeier, both of whom are also on our list of greatest choreographers of 20th century. Cranko's talent as storyteller, with a sense of fine shading of the story, his clear dramatic structure, and then an exceptional way in which he mastered the art of pas de deux, won over audiences worldwide. He passed away unexpectedly at the age of 46, cutting short his creative journey. Another American on our list, and this time quite different from what we have seen till now, nevertheless, is Bob Fosse, who made a huge contribution to the development of dance and choreography. He was perhaps the most influential figure in the field of jazz dance in the 20th century.
Who's got the pain when they do the mambo? Who's got the pain when they go erp? Who's got the pain when they do the mambo? I don't know who.
Do you? Who needs a pill when they do the mambo? Who needs a pill when they go ah? Who needs a pill when they do the mambo? I don't know who. Do you? Someone must be sick with the heat or stepping on everyone's feet. But if everyone's feeling okay, why don't they just say ole when the music carries them away? Who's got the pain when they do the mambo? Who's got the pain when they go ah? Who's got the pain when they do the mambo? I don't know who. Do you?
Bob Fosse forever changed the way audiences around the world view dance on stage and in film industry in the late 20th century. Visionary, intense and unbelievably driven, Fosse was an artist whose work was always provocative, entertaining and quite unlike anything ever seen before. Fosse forged an uncompromising modern style characterized by finger snapping, tilted bowler hats, net stockings, sprayed gloves fingers, turning knees and toes, that has frequently been called cynical. Influenced by work of Jack Cole, Fred Astaire and Jerome Robbins, Fosse was fluent in a variety of dance styles, from ballet to tap dancing to can-can. For his work on Broadway, Fosse won an unprecedented 8 Tony Awards. All That Jazz is perhaps his most famous creation. Last choreographer on this part one of the greatest choreographers of 20th century is the French Maurice Bejart, who is known for combining classical ballet, modern dance and jazz and acrobatics. In 1959, he became artistic director of Ballet the 20th Century, which became one of the foremost dance company in the world. In 1997, the troupe moved to Lausanne, Switzerland, and was renamed Bejart Ballet Lausanne. In 1992, he founded École Atelier Rudra Bejart, which to this day is regarded one of the best dance schools in the world. Thank you for watching this video, and don't miss part 2, where we will have a look at the rest of the greatest choreographers of 20th century.